SNEK is a 3D puzzle platformer by Sumo Digital, and it is a game I've been wanting to play for a very long time. And it's finally here, and it's out for a lot of different things, like PC. I know it's out for the Nintendo Switch, so if it's good, I actually might buy it for my kids to play as well, even though I'm playing on the Steam version right now. But it's also out for, I believe, PS4. And also Xbox One, I believe. If I got that, I'm pretty sure that's what's out. It's out for a lot of things today. And so far, I'm having a lot of fun with it. I'm on the fourth level here. I did the first three. That way, I could kind of get the hang of the game so I didn't look like such an idiot. And then also so that I could get all the boring tutorial areas down. I'm pretty sure we're done with that. Now it's just your snaky goodness. This is Noodle. He is, I believe, I fell off the edge. He is, I believe, a coral snake. Like, I think it's like an eastern coral snake, I believe. Although he could be the other one. I think it's a water moccasin or water snake or something. I'm not quite sure. There's two of them that look really similar. And I'm pretty sure the one that's red and then like a whitish yellow, black, and then a whitish yellow, and then red again, like he has on his back. I'm pretty sure that that is the coral snake. But either way, this game so far has been fantastic. It's not very easy. You'll see there's little sections like this that are a little bit difficult. So we're gonna need help from our friend here. Come help me, friend. Thank you. Oh, nope, we fell to our deaths. All right, we'll go ahead and let go, I suppose. And this is Noodle the Snake. I think I said that already. Sorry, SNEK, not snake. He's a SNEK. Yes. If you're a Redditor, you'll understand. But anyways, he's a danger noodle. I'm not quite sure the name of the hummingbird. He talks a lot, but he's never said his name. I'm not quite sure what his name is, but you climb in this game by coiling yourself around stuff. So I'll show you. You can like go like this and coil around it. And I was a little bit skeptical the first time I saw it because I wasn't sure how we were going to be able to control the snake. All right, we're going to try this one last time. But we're going to coil. And we are going to coil nice and tight. Like that. There we go. And then get it and come back. No, come back. No. I'm not very good at this game. But you know what? That's okay. Let's keep going forward. So I like the little things in this game. Like if you just go straight, hold on. If you just go straight like this, you slow down because you're not going very fast. But if you do what a snake would do, and you coil yourself back and forth like this, then you actually get a little speed boost, which I think is pretty cool. It's a little hard to show you while I'm climbing on stuff. Yeah, I'll show you in a second. But anyways, coil up here like this. So if you go like this, nope, that's not it. You go like this, you go faster. That was a very, very poor demonstration. So like this. Oh, I forgot, I'm hitting A. That's because I'm an idiot. A is for idiot, apparently. Let's go this way. Now, the goal in this game is to collect these multicolored stones, of which there are currently three in each level, and those will open up your gate to the next area. So that is what you do. Now, the good thing is there's a lot of little secret areas like this with cool stuff to find. There's 20 each of these, like, water, magic water droplets, or I'm not quite sure what they're supposed to be. There's 20 of those in each level for you to grab. And then there's also 5 gold coins, which are a little bit more hidden. I wouldn't be surprised if we've already passed several of them. I know where one of them was. It's that area I kept dying. Oh, there's a thing up there. So let's see if we can go grab that. Oh, and a checkpoint. Perfect. All right. And there's some sort of a bridge or something here. So that'll be a great mechanic for me to show you. Or a great place for me to show you the mechanics, rather. We're going to come up here, and we're going to coil around. And then you can, if you use your left trigger, and I do suggest that you use a controller for this game, because analog sticks, definitely very useful. If you use the triggers, stay. Nope, I got to go back up again. If you use the left trigger, you will coil like closer. You can coil a little bit tighter. There we go. Sorry about that. Make a nice little snake circle there. All right, cool. Now let's try this one here again. So we're going to go ahead and coil nice and tight. And we're going to have our friend lift us up here. He or she, not quite sure, will help you with your tail sometimes. So we're going to go ahead and coil up here. I see a coin there on the right. So let's coil nice and tight around this. Maybe if I could do it, that'd be great. Oh, nope. Come on. I am failing horribly. It's okay. You know what? That's okay, guys. There we go. We got the last one. Let's go ahead and just get out of this area. There we go. Perfect. Not quite sure how we're going to get that coin. There's stuff over here for us to do. So let's check out and see what's over here. And each one of these is like a cool little area to explore. And I've seen videos of a little bit later in the game, and there's actual puzzles where you have to like push things into areas and that kind of stuff. So this is the last area. This is where all of those stones go. So I see there's one. So you can see it up there. There's one up there. So we have to find our way up. And I believe that's it right there. That's where we are going to go next. Although let's check out this area really quick. There's a lot of little hidden secret areas. It pays to check them out for sure. Here we go. All right. Go ahead and grab that. Thank you. And we're going to go back here. I bet you anything there's something over here. There it is. Yep. I was right. It's a gold coin. Excellent. Ooh, can we go up? It's a little bit hard. No, we can't. The camera does its best, but games like this have always had issues with cameras. So, by the way, I should mention that I am a huge fan of 3D platformers that are done right. 3D platformers that are done right. Not the ones that are not that great. But when I was a kid, I grew up with Spyro the Dragon and several other 3D platformers that I remember very fondly. I loved them. They're good games. I'm a little bit sad when I see the Skylanders stuff because I feel like they're like, hey, we can just make money off of this series that people probably in their like 20s to 30s played when they were kids and probably loved. And we're just going to use it to make money by selling toys to kids. That's pretty much what happened, which is kind of sad. Also, did you see there's apparently a new there is a new Banjo-Kazooie game coming out. Well, kind of. It's a ukulele. I'm actually using this game to tide me over until I get that one, to be honest. Ooh, look at that tricky wrap there. I'm not going to make it, though. I really want that orb. I'll get it later, though. That's fine. Let's go up here. So, go ahead and stuff like this. Usually, you can just kind of climb up like this. I really like the simplistics of the movement system in this game. It works better than you think that it would. So, which is cool. I like it. So, we are about to get the last gate key here. And if we wanted to, let's see, there's a coin. There's the coin. I think we can get it from the top of this. We're going to try it out. If we wanted to, we could end the level here, or we could try and get all the coins and everything. See, there we go. Coin obtained. Yes, that is right. We'll just come over here. Grab that so that we don't lose our progress. Yeah, so we could get going to the next area if we want, or you can try and find all of the stuff and then also all of the things. If you really want to, there's a little area here to the right we haven't explored. So we're going to try that out here in a second. See, can we go this way to get there? It looks like it. Yes, we can. This might be the cheatery way, because look, we're already halfway up. Okay, here's the bottom. Gotcha. All right, let's try this one out, then we'll go to the next area. There's also a little water orb there that looks like it's going to be very difficult to get to. See, so there's a lot of cool little areas like this. We have to kind of figure out the best way to get up. There we go. And somebody better than me is probably, would probably already be up there already. Go ahead and coil really tight. Not really what I wanted to do. All right, let's do that. Oh, there's a coin up here. All right, cool. This will be, I think, our third coin. Got it. Got it. No, don't fall off. Don't. Okay, we fell off. Well, that was the thing. Let's just go ahead and head to the next area here. And I'll come back and I'll finish these off probably if I want to. But in the meantime, let's go to the next area. And how do we get there? I don't remember. It's over here, isn't it? Yes, that's it right there. All right, cool. We're almost there. But yeah, I'm really enjoying this game. It's like I said, it's probably what's going to tide me over until Ukulele comes out, which is, I believe, kind of middle of next month or late next month. All right, so this will open up this gate, and then from there, we can head on to the next level. And I kind of want to see if they add something new, because the first two levels were about climbing. The third and the fourth one were kind of more like advanced ways to climb, like where you can coil around stuff. The first two were pretty easy. Oh, what is this? Is this the bad guy? Oh, this may be a good guy. Not quite sure. Take this as our things. Oh, we got a thing. We did a thing, guys. What do we get? We got some sort of coin that our friend ate. Our gluttonous friend ate our coin. There we go. And off to the next area. So every one of these is a pretty small little area. You'll see, like, we're missing quite a bit of stuff. Not quite sure. Time trial mode. Okay, cool. So there's a time trial mode as well. I did not know that. That makes sense, though. That's for people who are much better at the game than I am right now, because I'm not doing very well. Please add something new, because I've seen in videos other cool stuff, right? All right, how are we going to get this? That is not... Okay, we did get it. That is true. But not in a way that we could retain our health. I'm wondering if we kind of go back and, you know, let's go this way and then this way. If our tail... Come on. Our tail, if we could grab it with our tail, you know? Oh, no, little birdie friend. You dropped us. How could you? That's okay. So, yeah, you know, these types of games, always check behind you. There's usually cool stuff. Now, the good thing about being a snake is you can go in the water. It doesn't hurt you. Oh, this is new. See, I was hoping they would add something new. So you can dive deep into the water now. Oh, that's cool. Is there a breath bar? So you kind of float up as you go a little bit, and then you can also swim up using A. Okay, cool. Awesome. I like this. See, they're adding new stuff, and we're only 5 levels in, so I can only imagine all the really cool stuff they add in the future. Gotta find all 20 orbs. You gotta catch them all. Snakeymon. I'm not quite sure. But anyways... This is like a snake temple. There's a switch! Oh, that's lots of new stuff. Awesome. I wonder what happens if you use it. Well, let's find out. I like how we're wet now. Did you notice? We've got a little sheen. We've got a little sheen to us. That's not what I wanted. Help me, birdie friend. Nope. We got a little sheen. It's the little things like that, you know? Honestly, I really don't have anything bad to say about this. The only bad thing I have to say about it is that the worlds are a little bit slow, and unpopulated, I would have preferred. How do we use the switch? Oh, wait a second. We coil around it? Oh, you just sit on it? Okay, that was it. Perfect. Oh, and there's one of the gate stones or whatever you want to call them. Now, I'm sure I would have been positive there would have been another one of those little gold coins over there, but there wasn't. Let's grab this really quick before we go. Which it looks like we couldn't have gotten to until we opened that door, because that door is a stepping stone to get to it. There we go. My biggest complaint with this so far is I'm used to these type of games having a whole cast of characters, right? With all sorts of cool stuff to do. And this game so far has only really had, I guess you could count, four characters. You got Noodles the Snake, you have whatever the bird's name is, not quite sure. You have the enemy, which flew overhead in an earlier one. You couldn't see what it is, but it looked like maybe some sort of an eagle or something. Not quite sure. There is a coinage there. It would be nice to have. Don't fall off. Don't fall off, buddy. Don't do it. I wonder if we could fall down. And I'll be honest, I'm not really keen on figuring that part out for myself. So we're not going to. Are we playing the drums? Because that is freaking amazing. And then, of course, the fourth person would be that, I don't know, Ooga Booga guy or whatever that just gave us that coin in the last bit. Oh, man, you can swim super fast when you do that. Oh, we missed one. Not that great at aiming this yet. That's okay. I probably miss all sorts of things. There's also, I mean, there's cool attentions to detail like that turtle and stuff. Actually, that would be a tortoise. I learned that the other day. I got corrected. The difference between a turtle and a tortoise, which I thought was backwards. Apparently, tortoises live on land and turtles live in the water. Who would have known? Apparently, people that watch my videos know that. Which I'm glad, because I get to learn stuff, and I get to learn how smart all of you guys are, and how dumb I am, apparently. That's okay. Okay, there is a thing we can push. There we go. We're doing it. Are you guys proud of us? I'm proud of me. I hope you guys are as well. We did a thing. Go down the hole. Do it. This reminds me of Zelda. I've been playing Breath of the Wild, and there's these switches we have to throw the balls in like that as well. And that's what it reminds me of. Hole in one, achievement unlocked. That's just proof that I did it. All right, cool, awesome. Let's go ahead and we will head this direction. Coil a little bit tight around this, if I could. There we go, thank you. And then over here, okay, cool. And coil, and coil. And lots of amazing coils. Oh, that was just perfect. That was just phenomenally done, Sea Otter. There we go. Is there anything under here? There is stuff under here. Awesome. So yeah, so I'm enjoying this game a lot so far. It's got very unique mechanics I haven't seen before. What other games can you say that you have to coil around something like a snake? I used to play Snake on my graphing calculator when I was a kid. And that's the only thing I can think of that would be even remotely similar. Okay, we need to go around in that way. I hear a coin or something. Oh, no, there's a thing. Let's grab that first before we miss it. There we go. And we'll save. Save points, very generous to have them everywhere. Is there anything over here? Not really. Okay. That's cool. Let's go ahead and go this way. We'll go up that little thing that we missed and see what's up here. The camera controls, they're okay, but they're not the greatest. I guess that's probably my only really big criticism, is the camera is not fantastic. I believe it's probably hard to do with a game like this. Go ahead and coil around this a little bit better. Thank you. Birdie friend, if you don't mind, much appreciated. Okay, we got this. Great. And let's see. Nope, we missed. Oh, birdie friend's helping. Nope, we fell down. Try it one more time. I'm assuming that there's a delicious, nutritious gold coin here at the top. Would be my assumption. And I wish I could coil up and down around stuff. It's probably possible. It's probably how you're supposed to do a lot of this stuff. All right, we're gonna stop that. We'll try and get this instead. How do we get up there? We may have to go the way that we just failed at to get up there. I guess we'll do that. Oh, look, there's stuff. Yeah, definitely look around. That's how you get all of the collectible items. Because they're pretty hidden. There's one, I think it was the third level or something, that I was looking for just one of those orbs. I had all of the coins, and I had 19 orbs, and it took me probably a good 20 minutes to find out it was behind a cliff. Like in a weird spot behind a cliff. So they're hidden, nevertheless. You know, to definitely look around. And that goes for any games like this, you know? 3D, I can talk, I promise. 3D puzzle platformers like this. There we go. Go ahead and coil around this. I am the greediest danger noodle. Okay. Go ahead and do that. And we will wrap ourselves very tightly around this. And then use it to propel ourselves over here. And wrap around, and oh, we did it! We did the thing I was wondering if we could do. Awesome. I feel accomplished. I can go about my day now knowing that I accomplished something menial in a children's video game. Okay, oh, there's a switch here. Probably a good thing to do. Probably a good thing we came up here. Okay. We could actually activate it without falling down. That would be best. There we go. Okay. The trick was that you have to kind of coil yourself around it very tight and then move off to the side. Excellent. Go ahead and go this way. Excuse me. Oh, yeah, we can go under it. Okay. I thought that was the thing that went up. It was. So we'll just figure out this last little bit here, end off this level, and then we'll probably end it there. And if you want to check this game out for yourself, I will leave everything that you need down below to do it for yourself. But, you know, like I said, I do have this on the PC. I'm thinking about getting it for the Switch. And partly because the Switch doesn't really have a lot of games right now. And I think this would be one that my kids would very much enjoy playing, you know? So, yeah, I think I'll probably do that. I'm wondering how well it works with the Switch. I would assume it works pretty well. My only complaint would be that the controller on the Switch may not be accurate enough for this level of movement. There we go. We didn't get all the things, but we got a lot of the things, and we got the three main things, so there's that as well. All right, and that is it, my friends. That is Snake Pass. If you want to check it out for yourself, I will leave a link down below to do so. Yeah, we didn't get a lot of stuff. Oh, actually, we got more of those than I thought we would have. So, fantastic. Lots of snake puns as well in this game. So, yeah, if you want to check it out for yourself, I will leave a link down in the description for you to do so. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in the next episode.